Speaking on the incident, the State Commissioner for Energy and Natural Resources, Peter Mide, disclosed that investigations into both incidents would unravel the actual causes. The incident comes barely a day after an explosion rocked an illegal oil dump site in Rumokoro Axis of Obio Akpo, local government area of the state. At number 5, the spokesman to President Muhammadu Buhari, Femi Adesina, has said that the federal government will only address areas within the white paper report of the Lagos Judicial Panel on Police Brutality that concerns it, as the date for the official submission draws near. Adesina made this known on Monday during an interview on Channel's TV program. He said definitely when the reports come out, the ones that are federal in nature will be considered. Speaking further, Adesina said that the federal government did not give a directive for their setup, but it was just an idea suggested to the state government. At number 4, the Osun State Governor Adeboyega Oyetola has released the sum of 708 million naira for the payment of pension to retirees in the state. This was made known in a statement by the state's head of service, Festus Olowogboyega Oyebade, on Monday. The breakdown of the payment, according to the statement, indicated that the sum of 508 million, 150 million, 50 million was approved to pay pensions of retired civil servants under the old pension scheme, pay selected retirees based on merit under the contributory pension scheme, and be used to offset part of the gratuities of retired officers under the old pension scheme, respectively. At number 3, a federal high court in Abuja has adjourned the case involving Omoyele Sowore's charges of treasonable felony to March 2022. The activist was expected to take a fresh plea before Justice Obiara Oguatu on Monday following the transfer of the former trial judge, Justice Ijeoma Ojukwu, to Calabar in Cross River State. However, it was gathered that the prosecutors were not present in court, while the court authorities refused to inform the activist lawyers. Recall that the Department of State Services had earlier arraigned Sowore and Olawale Bakare before Justice Ojukwu for treasonable felony for organizing the Revolution Now protest on August 5, 2019. At number 2, an NSAS protester, Kamsi Yochukwu Ibe, who testified before the Lagos State Judicial Panel of Inquiry on restitution for victims of SARS-related abuses and other matters, Lagos NSAS panel, was being attacked by unknown assailants with machetes on Sunday night. Ibun Adeboruwa, a panel member, made this known via his social media page. He stated that the assailant clearly wanted to kill her and urged the public to hold the government responsible if anything happens to him. At number 1, the scheduled arraignment of a former Minister of Aviation, Senator Stella Odua, before Justice Iyang Ekwo of the Federal High Court Abuja was on Monday stalled. The arraignment billed for today was scuttled by a petition written against the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission by co-defendants to Mrs. Odua in the criminal charges. Justice Ekwo adjourned the case till February 10, 2022 for the adoption of the written addresses and also ordered that Mrs. Odua and other defendants should continue to enjoy the bail earlier granted to them. Always remember to wash your hands, wear your mask and stay safe. That's all for now. See you next time on What's Happening.